क्वेश्चन नंबर 4.215. A non-relativistic proton enters in half space along the normal to the transverse uniform magnetic field, whose induction B is equals to 1.0 Tesla. Find the ratio of energy lost by proton due to radiation during its motion in the field to its initial kinetic energy. Okay. So, there is a proton which enters in a transverse magnetic field, and just covers a semicircular path and returns back from the medium. So, we have to find out the energy radiated to the initial kinetic energy. Okay. So, suppose this magnetic field intensity is V. This charged particle is moving with initial velocity V in the magnetic field. Okay, and its charge is Q, or basically proton. So, its charge is equivalent to charge of an electron. Okay. So, we can apply the basic concept that for the circular motion, that mv square r is equals to ev into v. From there, we can get the expression of speed, that is B E R over M. Okay, so from here, we can calculate the initial energy of the proton. Initial energy is half mv square. So, it will give us the expression, it will put B equals to V E R. So, this is V square E square R square divided by 2m initial kinetic energy. Okay, so this is our first expression. Now, when proton will move in magnetic field, then it will radiate certain amount of energy. Okay, and this radiated power can be measured using Larmor's equation. There is one equation, Larmor's equation, that gives us expression of radiated power. Radiated power can be written as 2 by 3 q square, q is magnitude of charge, into v square, its velocity, divided by c cube. Okay. So, in this case, as proton is moving in magnetic field, then radiated power can be written as p equals to 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught 2 by 3 c cube. Okay, into V square, and for that here we can write EV square over R into whole square. Okay. Now, this velocity is already known. This is VER over M. We can substitute this V square as VER over M. Then radiated power can be written as 1 over 4 pi epsilon naught into 2 by 3 c cube into e into b square e square r square over m square into r, okay, and total whole square. Okay, now we already know that power into time is equals to energy. Okay, so first we need to calculate how much time it will take to return back from the magnetic field. So, it is completing semicircular path. Okay, so radius of this path is known. Okay, and speed in this field is known. So, we can calculate time required in this field. That is, time is, because it is covering only half path, so this is pi r over its speed, which is BER over M. Okay. So, from here, we will get T equals to pi M into B, because it is completing only half cycle. So, energy radiated, or you can say energy lost, is radiated power into time. Okay. So, this radiated power is known. We can use 1 over 4 pi epsilon naught, or we can just write 6 pi into c cube into, if we'll open this term, e cube, so e to power 6. We can write b to power 4, e to power 6, and r to power 3 upon m to power 4 into this, that is multiplied by pi m over be. Okay. So once we can again just simplify this expression, let's take what common terms are removing here. We can cancel pi, we can cancel 1 power of m. So let's write a fresh equation, that 1 over 6 epsilon naught c cube into b cube e to power 5 r cube divided by m cube. Okay, this is radiated power, and we already calculated the initial power in this system. Okay, so if we'll just divide these two expressions, delta omega upon initial kinetic energy, then we'll get be cube over 3 epsilon naught c cube into m square. Okay, b is 1 tesla already given, e is charge of an electron, that is our proton, 10 to power minus 19 coulomb, epsilon naught is known, speed of light is known, mass of proton is known. If we'll put all these values, then we'll get 2.06 into 10 to power minus 18, the ratio of radiated energy and initial energy of this proton.